electric and delicious. We're making butternut squash soup, and with a little twist, we also add some coconut sour cream. So I hope you guys try this recipe and enjoy it. Alright, so we're gonna cut the ends of the squash first. Make sure you have a nice sharp knife. Alright, and then we're gonna cut it in half. Doesn't directly have to be in half, but as close as possible. Because my squash ain't cut it in half. Alright. We'll cut it in another piece. Also roast the seeds if you like, but right now we're just gonna focus on making the soup. All right, after we're done slicing and cleaning out our butternut squash, we're going to put as much seasoning as you like. So I'm gonna put a dash of cayenne pepper on each piece of butternut squash. You can also boil this, but I find that baking this, it's a lot easier because if you boil it, it takes a really long time to cut up. Whereas this way, you just cut it up in three pieces and bake it, and you just leave it in for an hour. All right, so I have my cayenne. I'll put a dash of onion powder. So after seasoning our butternut squash, we are also going to add our bell peppers, onions, tomatoes, and all that good stuff. And we're gonna put just a little bit of smoked sea salt on there. A little bit of cayenne. Just a dash. And this way, the reason why I'm adding the seasoning is so it can be basically marinated and with the veggies. All right, now that all of our vegetables are seasoned, we're just gonna pop this in the oven. And make sure that my squash is properly baked. So, we're gonna use the old-fashioned way of checking to see if something is al dente. So we're gonna take our handy dandy knife, and if it can go straight through, then it is ready. If it can't, if it doesn't, then we need to put it in for a little bit more time. So it passed the test. All right, I guess it's all ready. So before we scoop this out, we are going to let it sit for a few minutes, and we are going to prepare our coconut sour cream. We are going to use basically a fourth of this packet of coconut cream. All right, we're gonna pour it into here. Okay. So this much should be fine, just a fourth of the packet, because this is very concentrated. We're also going to input two key limes. You're going to take the seed out, of course. And now we're going to add our spices. We're going to add 1/4 of smoked sea salt, 2 dashes of cayenne, or as much as you like. We're also going to input 1/4 of teaspoon of onion powder. You can also add a little bit of dill weed. Add in some fresh onion, just a slice of it. We can add 1/4 cup of spring water. And we are just going to blend for 2 minutes, or until it is nice and smooth. After the 2 minutes up, you are going to test it just to make sure the texture and taste is to your liking. If not, you can just add more seasoning, but this is perfect for me. The texture and taste is just phenomenal. So I'm just gonna let it sit here for a few minutes while I get started on the sage. So to make our delicious sage sauce, we are going to add just a little bit of oil. And that will be like 1/2 teaspoon of grapeseed oil. We are going to input 4 leaves of sage. You can add more or less. I think I'll just add more. We're also going to roast it with some. Alright. I am also going to add the rest of our seasoning, our roasted seasoning. So after the squash has completely cooled down, there's multiple ways you can do this step. You can either use a knife and just try to get the skin off, or you can scoop it out. I find the fastest way is to get a knife and just to approximate exactly where the skin is from the squash. It just makes it faster for me. I feel like when I scoop it out, it's very time consuming. But this method, you have to be very careful that you're not wasting the squash. You just have to be very gentle. Thank you. before we puree the soup, we're gonna add a little bit more raw spices. We're basically gonna add a fourth of all of the spices that we did before. Just a little bit of oregano. Onion powder. And of course, our sea salt. Alright, so now we are going to puree our soup. Stick blender, or you can use an actual blender if you don't have this, but you have to let this soup cool down before you use an actual blender. This is basically a comfort food, so play with it, add, subtract, whatever you like. So try it and let me know what you guys think in the comments, and like, comment, of course, and subscribe. Peace.